Princess Icy, and I'm back with another video. Tonight's topic is going to be milk snakes. And this video is for anyone who wants a milk snake, is considering getting a milk snake, or already has one. And in this video, I'm going to be going over the basic needs, and only the basic needs, to keep a milk snake. And nothing too fancy. So, let's get right into it. The first thing that you're going to need, obviously, is its habitat. So, I just got my first milk snake in March, and he's the first reptile that I've ever had. I've never had any type of reptiles, no frogs, no lizards. And my experience so far with him is he's very skittish. And I heard most baby snakes are very skittish, but yeah. And the habitat that I got from him, I got him from Petco, and I got his habitat and all his needs from Petco too. Or no, not Petco, it was PetSmart. PetSmart. So if you want a milk snake, 9 times out of 10, they'll have one there. If you want the supplies to get one, 9 times out of 10, they'll have everything there. And for his habitat, I have a 10-gallon terrarium that I picked up from PetSmart. It came with the 10-gallon tank. It came with the lid, it came with the thermometer, and it came with the lamp. But the lamp that came with it, I don't use. I actually got my own UVB light that I use for them. And technically, they don't need the UVB light, but if you want one, you should definitely get a heating lamp and a heating pad, because he's gonna need his own warm side for his tank, and he's gonna need his own cold side for his tank. So you're gonna definitely have to get a heat lamp, and you're gonna definitely have to get a warming pad. But if you want substrate, then you should get wood chips. Wood chips is what I use for my substrate. And it's a lot of other things you can use for substrate, but I just use wood chips. And you can find those at PetSmart too. And his habitat cost me about maybe $50, $60, $70 at the most. But you're gonna need a terrarium, you're gonna need the heat lamp, you're gonna need the heat pad, you're gonna need a thermometer, you're going to need a spray bottle for humidity, and you're gonna need his food pan, his dish, his water dish, and you're gonna need his substrate. So here's the substrate that I use for my milk snake, and their wood chips, or their bark, might as well say wood chips. And it says they're good at absorbing and retaining moisture. It helps with the humidity in the tank and keeping the humidity in the tank, so it's really good. And my milk snake likes to burrow under it and hide in it. This is the water bottle that I use to humidify his cage. Any water bottle will do. I got this from Dollar Tree. Like I said, any water bottle will do. It doesn't have to be fancy. You want to at least keep 30 to 60% humidity in his tank. I usually spray it on his cool side. And really, you don't have to do it every day, but as long as you keep it humid. When it comes to feeding, I feed my milk snake pinky mice. Make sure you don't do what I did and go and get larger mice on accident, because he will not be able to eat them. It has to be pinky mice. And then the way I defrost them is I use my hair dryer to defrost them. Make sure that they're all the way defrosted, because it can be hard for them to swallow. But once you've defrosted them, I use tongs and I wave it in front of his mouth so he can sense it is there, because you know snakes sense heat. So I wave it around his mouth until he snatches it. And then once he snatches it, he'll do the rest on his own and he'll swallow it. One more thing to mention about milk snakes is they do not need a partner. They like living on their own. And more than likely, if you try to house them with other milk snakes, then they might just try to eat each other. So it is definitely not a good idea, and I definitely do not recommend that you try to house them with other milk snakes or any other type of snake. So that is my milk snake. He does not like being fluid. Like I said, they're very skittish. If you walk around away from the tank, then 99% of the time they're gonna hide. 99% of the time you have one, they're gonna hide. And really, if you want them to come out more, you can try to be interactive with them, or maybe try to put a branch like I had in there so they can come out and lay on the branch or curl around the branch. But 9 times out of 10, they like to hide, so they're gonna hide. Last part being their temperature and what temperature you should keep their habitat. You should have a cool side and a warm side, as it is for most snakes. And their cool side should be at least in the 70s, and their warm side should be at least in the 80s. You won't gonna wanna put your lamp and your heating pad on the warm side and put their water dish on the cool side. As far as the humidity goes, I spray the water on the cold side. It's up to you whether you want to spray the water on the cold and warm side, but usually I spray the water on the cold side. But my snake spends a majority of his time on the cooler side, but you're gonna want to have to make sure you have both. But that pretty much sums up the video. Definitely the basic things, at least, that you would have to get for them. As far as the UVB light and stuff, it's gonna benefit their health, but it's not a necessity for you to have, just to keep one. There's plenty of stuff, more stuff that I can name that you would probably just get if you just want their health to just be a top notch. But these are all the basic things just to be able to keep one and just have it survive, period. But thanks for watching my videos. Please like, please subscribe. If you like my video, then I'll follow up with one showing me feed him. But that's all, guys. Thanks for watching my video. Please like, please subscribe, and peace out.